Welcome to a video on transforming an augmented matrix into row echelon form to solve a system of equations. Let's first review what row echelon form is. An augmented matrix is in row echelon form if the main diagonal consists of ones or zeros and all of the elements under the main diagonals are zeros. So here are the main diagonals, and those must be ones or zeros, and then the elements under the main diagonal must be zeros, as we see here, and also as we see here. Let's take a look at how we're going to transform the augmented matrix into row echelon form. What we're allowed to do is interchange two rows. We're also allowed to multiply the elements of any row by a non-zero real number, and we can also add and subtract the corresponding elements of any two rows, and this process is called Gaussian elimination. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Let's start by writing this system as an augmented matrix. The first row would be 2, negative 3, 18. And the second row would be 5, 2, 7. Let's go ahead and draw a vertical line here to separate the coefficients from the constants. Now our first goal is to get a 0 in this position. Since the corresponding element is a 2, the least common multiple of 5 and 2 would be 10. So if this was a positive 10, this was a negative 10, we could add them together to make this 0. So we'll multiply row 1 by negative 5, multiply row 2 by 2. So the first row would become negative 10, positive 15, and negative 90. And row 2 would be 10, 4, and 14. Now we're going to go ahead and replace row 2 with row 2 plus row 1. This should give us the 0 that we need in this position. The first row stays the same. For row 2, we're going to have 10 plus negative 10, that's 0. 5 plus 15, that's 19. And 14 plus negative 90, that's negative 76. Now we want a main diagonal of 1s, so we're going to multiply row 1 by negative 1/10, which is the same as dividing by negative 10. We'll multiply row 2 by 1/19, or divide by 19. So this would be a 1, negative 1/10 times 15, or 15 divided by negative 10, that's negative 3/2. And negative 1/10 times negative 90 would be 9. And then row 2, we have 0, this would be 1, and 1/19 times negative 76 would be negative 4. Now this is in row echelon form. Let's go ahead and rewrite this as a system, and it should be much easier to solve. This first equation would be x minus 3/2 y equals 9. And the second equation would be y equals negative 4. So now we know that y is equal to negative 4, we can perform back substitution to determine x. So we'll have x, this would be minus negative 12/2 or plus 6. So we have x equals 3. So we found the solution to the system using an augmented matrix in row echelon form. X equals 3 and y equals negative 4. Let's go ahead and try it on a system of three equations in three variables. And this is going to take a little bit more work. Let's go ahead and write our augmented matrix. The first row would be 1, negative 1, 1, 2. Second row would be 3, negative 2, 1, negative 1. And row 3, there's no z term, so we're going to have 1, 1, 0 for the z term, and then negative 3. What we want to do now is start off by trying to get a 0 in this position and also a 0 in this position. So if you take a look at row 1 and row 3, if we replace row 3 with row 3 minus row 1, that would give us a 0 in this position. And then if you take a look at the first two rows, if we take this row and subtract 3 times this row, that would also give us a 0 here. So let's go ahead and do that as well. Let's go ahead and rewrite this now. First row stays the same. So for the second row, we're going to have 3 minus 3 times 1, that's 0. Negative 2 minus 3 times negative 1, that becomes negative 2 plus 3. That gives us a 1. And then 1 minus 3 times 1, that's negative 2. And negative 1 minus 3 times 2, that would be negative 1 minus 6, that would be negative 7. And the new row 3 will be 1 minus 1, that's 0. 1 minus negative 1, that's 2. 0 minus 1, that's negative 1. And then lastly, we have negative 3 minus 2, so negative 5. Now the next thing we want to do is have a 0 in this position. We want to work with row 2 and row 3, so we're going to take row 3 and replace it with row 3 minus 2 times row 2. First two rows stay the same. So for row 3, now we're going to have 0 minus 2 times 0, that's still 0. 2 minus 2 times 1, that's 0. Negative 1 minus 2 times negative 2, that'll become negative 1 plus 4, that's 3. And then we have negative 5 minus 2 times negative 7, which becomes negative 5 plus 14, that's equal to 9. Let's go ahead and take this over to the next screen. Our last step here is to make sure the main diagonal consists of ones or zeros. These two are already 1, but this one is a 3, so we need to multiply row 3 by 1/3, which is the same as dividing by 3. So again, the first two rows stay the same, and now we'll multiply this by 1/3. So we have 0, 0, 1, and then 9 times 1/3 is 3. Now that it's in row echelon form, we'll rewrite this as a system of equations. So the first row would be x minus y plus z equals 2. The second row would be y minus 2z equals negative 7. And the last row tells us that z is equal to positive 3. So we know z equals 3. Now we can perform back substitution to find x and y. Looking at this second equation, we have y minus 2 times z, which is 3, must equal negative 7. So we have y minus 6 equals negative 7. Add 6 to both sides, we have y equals negative 1. And now we'll use the first equation to determine x. So we have x minus y plus z, which is 3, equals 2. So we have x, this becomes plus 1 plus 3, so we have x plus 4 equals 2, so x equals negative 2. And now we have solved this system by using an augmented matrix in row echelon form. Okay, in the next video we'll talk about how to rewrite an augmented matrix into reduced row echelon form. It's a very similar process. As you begin to get a feel for working with augmented matrices, you can probably tell that it's very similar to using the elimination process. It's just that now, instead of using the equations, we're using a matrix. I hope you found this video helpful.